John chapter 10.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, the festival of dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was walking in the temple in the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly." And Jesus answered, "I have told you, but you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe because you do not belong to my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of my Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated. In today's gospel passage, it is late December, and Jesus is in Jerusalem for this festival of dedication, what we more commonly refer to as Hanukkah. He's there, he's present, and he's walking through the temple, and outside the temple there's a big courtyard. And there's a series of steps that then lead down into the lower part of the city. So from the top of these steps, you can see out onto the city. And there's these big, huge columns. And it's called Solomon's Portico. It's a place where the kings often would announce or pronounce their judgments, whatever they happen to be. Jesus is kind of walking through that area. And he's stopped by a number of people who know who he is, who have been intrigued by him. And they ask him a question. They're kind of frustrated. I can tell by their question. They come to Jesus and say, "All right now, enough is enough. Just tell us simply and plainly, are you the Messiah or not? Yes or no? Come on. We need to know." And you can almost, in the way they ask the question, you can feel, at least I can feel, maybe it's just me because I'm a Bible geek, I can feel their frustration. And of course, Jesus answers them in a very cryptic way. He goes on by talking, saying, "I have told you simply, you just don't understand because you're not one of my sheep." And although it might be a simple answer, it's not really, it's very actually cryptic. And with those words, Jesus starts off a theological controversy that has lasted for thousands upon thousands of years. Why don't people believe? Is it because God hasn't chosen them? Or is it because they don't have faith to believe? Which one is it? And that question, that controversy, still has not been resolved today, largely because there is no simple answer to that question. It's very complex. Both sides are true, and it's hard for us to grasp and figure that out. But Jesus, once again, not always saying or living up to what people want him to be. Now, I realize that many of us probably don't wake up in the morning worrying about the theological controversy of predestination versus free will. I doubt that's part of your coffee routine. But the scene that happens in Acts is something I think that we all wrestle with. In that scene, a woman who's a faithful woman in the church and a follower of Jesus has died. And Peter shows up on the scene and prays, and miraculously she raises from the dead. It's an incredible demonstration of the power of God working through Peter. And here we get to something that I think is a little easier for us to relate to. Because we've all been in that position where we've desired something really, really badly. And we've prayed, "God, please, if I could just have this one thing, please, please, please," and not gotten it. We've been there. If anybody's ever been in a desperate situation, you've prayed to God, whatever God is up in heaven, right? And you wanted to be rescued, or you wanted help, or you someone you love, you wanted help, only not to receive it. And we're left with this question in our minds. Why didn't God act? Is it because I didn't have enough faith? I wasn't good enough? Or is it because God doesn't have the kind of power to act that way anymore? Which is it? And the answer to that question, well, there's not a simple, easy answer to that question. And what happens is, because we don't discover a simple answer, sometimes in our hearts, we just kind of give up. We just put it off, we shelve it, we think, "Oh, that's just not for me to know." And we go on with our lives. And that's kind of tragic. tragic. And the reason is this. It is wrestling with these tough questions that helps to build our faith, and that there aren't always simple, easy answers or explanations of why things are happening around us, or where is God, why didn't God do something. We don't always know, we can't always tell the answer to those questions. We want, because of our culture, simple, easy to understand questions. Why? Because we want to go on living with our lives, and we'd rather that these tough questions were just settled so they don't worry us anymore. But this is the thing. Our faith is built as we wrestle with these questions. And sometimes we have to wait a long time, and maybe it might not be till we arrive in heaven that we actually discover the answer to some of these questions. And that's okay. Our theme during Easter is signs of hope and joy. So in the stories that we read, where do I find a sign of hope and joy? It's in this. Jesus says to his disciples, right after he gives that cryptic answer, but know this, my sheep know my voice. They hear from me, and they are mine, and no one can ever pluck them out of my hands. And what I take from that, what I learn from that, is that as I wrestle with these hard questions that sometimes can eat away inside of me if I actually pay attention to them, I don't wrestle alone. God is with me. Jesus is wrestling with me. He's cheering me on. He's even giving me pointers. He'll even wrestle with me in order to teach me. He'll pick me up, and I'll wipe away my tears, and I'll bandage my wounds. Jesus, not just figuratively, but literally, and I'm using that word correctly, is with us and wrestles with us and carries us. And that's our sign of hope and joy, because I don't always get simple answers. Sometimes I have to wrestle and allow my faith to grow as I trust God, but I take refuge in the fact that I don't wrestle alone. Amen.
Amen.
Let's stand for our song of the day.